We'll have, in fact, with us Mr. Nawal Ahuja, who's the co-founder and director of Exchange for Media Group, who will be spearheading this exciting session for all of us. So on that note, ladies and gentlemen, firstly, if you can please help me welcome on stage Mr. Nawal Ahuja, the co-founder and director, Exchange for Media Group.
Thank you, Kavya. Thank you for staying back on such a rainy day. And I hope over the next 30, 40 minutes or so, you'll find it worthwhile that you all stayed back. I have a very special guest with me who needs no introduction. I'm sure you've seen his name on the agenda already. Please give a very big round of applause to none other than Prasoon Joshi, who's with us today, the current chairman of CBFC and a fantastic creative genius of our country. Thank you, Prasoon bhai, for being here. Of course, you won't be surprised if I told you it took 2 hours for him to come from BKC to, this venue. He's been on the road last 2.5 hours. He got delayed. His session was originally scheduled to start at 3 o'clock. I know he does not need any introduction, but, just to contextualize our talk, I'd like to read out a few nuggets about Prasoon bhai's, life's journey and what he's done so far. As a lot of you would know already, he's a national award winner, an acclaimed industry leader. Prasoon exemplifies the rare breed of creativity and leadership. And I don't know how many of you actually know this. Prasoon Joshi went to IMT in Ghaziabad. He studied MBA there, and we will talk about that later as the chat goes on. And he also, I was reading on his website yesterday, he wrote his first poetry book when he was 17. Right, and I don't even remember what I was doing when I was 17. Most likely, video gaming with a friend or chasing girls. An advertising and communication icon who's built mega brands, a writer who's been honored with prestigious national award by the President of India. He also has garnered glory at the international awards like Cannes, DNAD, and plethora of others. I'm sure many of you still remember that in 2015, his very famous Happy Dent creative was awarded as the top global ad of all time, top 20 global ads of all time by the Gun Report. And that, that itself is a huge achievement if you don't count the others. As a chairman of McCann World Group Asia Pacific, he's credited with marrying creativity with scale and giving McCann's work in India a distinct cultural edge, making it a powerhouse that has had the pulse of the market and the consumer. His work for mainstream brands like Coca-Cola, MasterCard, Johnson & Johnson, Perfetti, Nestle, Maggi, and national ones like Dabur, Britannia, and more is well recognized. Current campaigns that bear Prasoon's indelible mark are Dettol, Banega Swachh India, Incredible India, UP Tourism Branding, and Mission Pani for Reckitt Benckiser. Content creation for brands in the music space for Coca-Cola or social projects like Malnutrition, Polio Eradication, Women Empowerment Ministry of Tourism, the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan have all won accolades and found deep and powerful consumer connect. His creativity as a writer-poet permeates the arena of celebrated Indian feature films, where he celebrated an award-winning song and screenwriter. Through his writing in films like Tare Zameen Par, Rang De Basanti, Bhag Milkha Bhag, Neerja and Manikarnika, he has rekindled the faith that one can give constructive direction to the society through high-caliber work in popular genre. His poems in various issues have found unique connection with the consciousness of the country. Prasoon is also a columnist writing on branding and social issues in leading business and daily publications. He has authored 5 books. Now, I did not know that. As I said, the first one was at 17, and his latest Thinking Aloud released recently in January this year. Designated a young global leader by the World Economic Forum, Prasoon has also been conferred the prestigious Padma Award by the President of India. Through his multifaceted pursuits and content creation across the fields of poetry, cinema, advertising, and music, he has positively impacted the public consciousness and has emerged as an iconic socio-cultural voice that resonates across segments. So again, a very big round. Please give a big round of hand to Prasoon for being here on a day like today. Prasoon bhai, let me start with the basics. We've gathered here today to discuss content and content curation, and you've been in that that domain, that industry, that business for, over 2 decades now. And the shape of content from when you started as a, creative person, and you continue to be a creative person, today what it is, it has significantly changed. and people, you know, talk today you talk to content guys and they'll tell you what data and analytics is. And when you started, you know, young in the creative business, creativity meant something else. We know the differences. What are the common things that, you know, creativity and content still have today?
Thank you for being here, and thank you for that embarrassing introduction. While you were talking, I suddenly started thinking about the ads we used to do even before my time in Doordarshan era. You could easily call those ads content because people looked forward to those ads as a piece of entertainment. They were perceived something other than ads. They were not out and out ads. People used to actually wait. Some of the people felt that the ads were more entertaining than the actual programs. So they were short stories, jingles, jokes. People consumed them as piece of entertainment, not merely piece of information, because there was a scarcity of entertainment at that time. Very little was available, especially in audiovisual. Very little was available. So even Bhulna Jana Isi Balblana, a child also sang with it. Or a joke which you saw on television in form of a... When I got attracted, see, I was writing much earlier than, you know, I was writing poetry, I was writing short stories. And then I happened to do, you know, I realized it was a 17-year... I mean, I realized very early that, you know, pet nahi bharega isse, to kuch aur karna padega. I didn't, my father, normally in families, parents have to drill it in your head that, listen, your guitar will not give you, you know, your living. You won't be able to earn from it. But I didn't need that. So I ended up doing my management realized that there is something called advertising. What attracted me to this profession at the time, that we were writing short stories. We were writing content. Actually, when you say content, it's how you define content. The question is how you define content. If you define advertising as a very narrowly, then you would be able to distinguish between the two and differentiate. But if you don't narrowly define, then I don't find anything, you know, unusual about it, because I've been doing it. I've been doing songs like Coke Studio. What do you call it? Content? Advertising? I mean, being part of Coke Studio for some time, and it's for me, it's content. So I think very easily if you compartmentalize them, you start saying that this is content, this is advertising, this is traditional advertising. What is traditional advertising? What is modern advertising? Whatever is working today is advertising. You are supposed to, how you define the profession is also important.
Tell me, that's a very good point. You know, I remember reading somewhere that last year you said that you've never seen ads and ads, but as short form content. Yes. And today, content is also being built as advertising. You go to a client, the client wants you to do content as an agency and not just create 30-seconders for them. What does this do to the creative business? You know, for somebody like you who's, you know, grown up doing, you know, short stories and curating content, it might come naturally. But for a young, you know, creative director, a young copywriter who was taught in his creative school to, you know, write 30-second ads, who is now being told by the client to, you know, create 30-minute fiction shows. Is it pitting the content industry against the, you know, people in the creative industry? Is the creative industry geared up to curate content the way clients are expecting?
You're forgetting one thing. Even if you have a great content, you will need to advertise the content. So, content ke baad bhi advertising ki aapko zarurat padegi for content itself. Today you are saying content is in contradiction with advertising. But content itself would require advertising. Sure. So how will you take content to people? So what you call advertising is a 30-second commercial. Yes, if you narrowly define advertising, then content will become segregated. But if you do not narrowly define it, then, you know, even product placement in films, which you used to do earlier, that was also advertising. I never saw it differently. I never saw a song like Banega Swachh India when we were doing that, the anthem which I wrote. Three different anthems for different people. One, I wrote this Swachh Bharat Ka Irada, which is all kude wali gaadiyon mein bachta hai. That's for the government. And then I did this Banega Swachh India, which with Indian Ocean did for Dettol. Now, what you call it? You call it content, call it ads. For me, I never define ads like my Thanda Matlab Coca-Cola series of ads were all, we never looked at the time. And I mean, client was very kind to tell us that whatever time you require, whether it's 30 seconds, 40 seconds, 80 seconds, doesn't matter.
Fantastic.
It needs to, yeah. So as far as you know, narrowly defined it, I would not find that content is in contradiction with advertising, and I do not find a segregation. You know, the biggest thing is, see, you look at the film star today. There was a mystique to the film star earlier. And I'm drawing a parallel between a film star and a brand here, just to make you understand. There was a mystique to the film star. You never saw your film star other than the film you watched. You went there, you didn't know what his life would be like, how he would be in everyday life. You saw the person larger than life on the screen, in awe. Aap aise dekhte the, bada screen hai. Aap uske samne the. You used to look up to that. Now you have a small screen and you're looking down. Now this changed the equation. Looking up like that in awe versus looking down. Achha, ye achha aapke dimag se nahi aa sakta tha kabhi pehle. Now, also the opportunities this film star has with you to interact. Uska ek tweet aa gaya hai. There is a TikTok video has come. There is some YouTube video is going on. Some television, news is happening. News room mein wo baith ke debate bhi kar rahe hain. Suddenly the mystique has ended. A relationship has got redefined. Brands also had very much, you know, this kind of relationship with the consumer. Brands only talk through ads. Ek baar aap se baat karne aate the, aur wo ads ke through karte the. And that is the representation of the old world, where there was an active performer, active advertiser, and a passive audience. What the reality of today is, you've got an active performer and an active audience. Now, this active performer and active audience is possible because of the connectivity we have, the internet, the social media. You have active performer and active audience. Immediately, you start getting feedback. So it's like a live performance. It's more like the tribal age earlier we had, where nobody performed for nobody. It was a collective, always. If you look at a tribal dances, and please go and if you can find some videos of tribal dances. There is not one condescending performer out there. This is somewhere in between it happened that condescension entered art, where you said, I am better than you, you better listen to me. I'm better performer than you, you sit, I will dance. This is not how humans behaved earlier. Human, by basic nature, create art collectively. So tribal dances and folk art has a lot of collective participation. On the spot creation happens. Lines are written, dance steps are done. Two people will sit, two people will get up. Now that's exactly what is getting replicated today. You see in performance, in through social media, and our today's stars are facing that they have to be ready to be all the time watched in their various mudras and various avatars. They are always available there, as our brand is. The brand is similar. Brand is out for scrutiny. Brand is coming out in various avatars and forms. If you're not comfortable with this reality, you will not be able to embrace content. You will have to embrace content because there are various. So don't be scared that I will lose my mystique. Yes, you will lose your mystique, but you will develop a very good relationship. And you have to know how to present yourself in various avatars of yours. And those are understood well if you have understanding of content.
Right, that's a good point. I want to ask you from, the brand side. There was an era when 60-second commercials used to be quite common, and then it came down to 30 seconds. That 30 seconds gradually, thanks to YouTube, became 10 seconds, and then that further got filtered down to 6 seconds. The commercials, I mean. Today, we live in an era where TikTok content videos are 6 seconds, and the ad videos, God knows, are becoming 2 seconds and 3 seconds and so on and so forth. What does it do to, you know, brand building? Because the traditional theories of brand building are all being kind of, you know, torn apart by this increasing short duration attention span social media and brands have to ride that bandwagon. There is no choice. But is it possible to build a brand today when you're doing 2 to 3 3-second commercials, and on top of that, given so much fragmentation, you know, I was watching in the morning, Pam Moore spoke. She's the owner of Marketing Nuts. She was talking about how daily YouTube is serving some 1.7 billion minutes of content worldwide. What does it do to brand building if you do a 3-second commercial and you are one out of, 300 or so?
देखिए बदहजमी तो है. एक माँ अपने बच्चे के लिए बेटे से कहती है, आज मैं छोला बना रही हूँ, जल्दी आ जाना, तेरे पसंद के छोले बना. वो पुराने ज़माने की बात होती, फटाफट ऑफिस से पैकअप करता, जल्दी घर पहुँचता, माँ छोले बने हैं, जल्दी से खिलाओ यार, मैं तो भूख बहुत लगी, मैंने दिन में से कुछ, मैं लंच भी स्किप कर दिया आज. टुडे द गाय हैज स्नैक्ड ऑल थ्रू, यू बीन स्नैकिंग. उसने वड़ा पाव भी खाया, उसने पिज्ज़ा भी खाया, उसने बर्गर भी खाया, उसने स्विगी से 3 बार ऑर्डर किया है. कि मतलब उसका बिल्कुल, बाय द टाइम ही रीच्ड होम, ही ओपन द डोर, मॉम सेज बेटा छोले, छोले मामा कल मैं खाऊंगा, आज पूरा मत मानो, मुझे बिल्कुल यू नो आई इंडाइजेशन हो गया, मैं तो इनो लेने जा रहा हूँ, एंड फ्रिज में रख दो, कल देखते हैं इसको, सुबह ब्रेकफास्ट में खाता हूँ. नाउ दिस इज व्हाट इज अ ओवरडोज ऑफ कॉन्टेंट टुडे. दैट फ्राइडे वेटिंग फॉर अ फिल्म, कि फ्राइडे को हमें याद है कि कुछ भी पिक्चर आ जाए, थिएटर एक दो ही होते थे, उनमें कोई भी पिक्चर लगी देखनी है. यू डो नॉट नो विच फिल्म इज इज, बट मूविंग पिक्चर विद डायलॉग्स एंड सॉन्ग्स इज अ नॉवेल्टी. नाउ दैट छोला दैट एंड पैरेलल टू दैट द फ्राइडे मूवी नाउ इज कम्पीटिंग विद द होल डे ऑफ स्नैकिंग. नाउ द स्नैकिंग विच इज हैपनिंग विद कॉन्टेंट इज क्रिएटिंग इंडाइजेशन. यस देर आर चैलेंजेस, ऑफकोर्स देर आर चैलेंजेस, बट लेट्स नॉट फॉरगेट, यस द वायरिंग ऑफ द ह्यूमन माइंड इज ऑल्सो चेंज्ड. I think today's generation wants things faster, the way they write it. But let's not forget, we also had haikus earlier. It's not that haiku was not an art form. In India, where there were, Hindi mein ek hota hai khand kavya, ek puri lambi kavita hoti hai, ki ek cheez ke upar puri puri pustak hai, wo ek hi kavita hai, ek hi cheez ke baare mein hai. Jai Shankar Prasad ki Aansu dekh lijiye, Kamaini dekh lijiye, is tarah se aap, अलग अलग राइटर्स, अच्छे अच्छे राइटर्स की होती थी. बट एट द सेम टाइम रहीम के दोहे भी होते थे, कबीर के दोहे भी होते थे, टू लाइन्स, दो लाइन में एसेंस होता था, एंड दे वर फैबुलस एंड वेरी पावरफुल पीसेस ऑफ पोइट्री. लॉट ऑफ पीपल रोट इन दैट एरा दोहा. दोहा वॉज अ फॉर्म ऑफ शॉर्ट फॉर्म ऑफ राइटिंग. सो क्या शॉर्ट फॉर्म में ब्रांड बिल्डिंग नहीं हो सकती? आई डोंट बिलीव दैट. इट इज पॉसिबल. क्या कह रहे हैं इस बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, और वो जो थॉट है वो क्या उसके लिए उपयुक्त है, इज इट सुटेबल टू बी डिलीवर्ड इन दैट फॉर्म, इन द कैप्सूल फॉर्म. नॉट एवरीथिंग कैन बी डिलीवर्ड, द सर्टन थॉट्स विच वुड रिक्वायर दैट काइंड ऑफ इमोशन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल अ रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन मॉम एंड सन और अ रोमांटिक मोमेंट विच रिक्वायर अ सर्टन पोर्ट्रेयल, अ सर्टन अ सॉन्ग विच इज यू नो a little lingering, has a lingering effect. Uski beats slower hain. Wo jo maine gana likha tha, jaise tere haath mein mera haath ho, wo usi tarah kaha ja sakta hai. Wo masti ki paathshala ki tarah nahi kaha ja sakta. To main masti ki paathshala likhunga to uski beats alag hongi, uska aur wo ek line mein masti ki paathshala. I remember we debated a lot whether koi samjhega ya nahi, but that capsule of masti ki paathshala, it became very popular after I wrote that. But nobody thought paathshala would become contemporary. It became contemporary after that. So that one coinage can deliver that. But tere haath mein main ruk jaunga agar, bhai kya tere haath mein, mera haath ho, phir kya, sari jannatein mere paas ho. ye uski zarurat hai. It is the need for that emotion that you write it like that, and that's why the form it would be required like that. So can things be said in, so कट अ लॉन्ग चेज, एक छोटे फॉर्म में कैन यू बिल्ड ब्रांड्स? यस. कैन यू डिलीवर इंफॉर्मेशन? यस. ऑफ अ सर्टन काइंड, ऑफ अ सर्टन काइंड ऑफ इमोशन, यस यू कैन बिल्ड दैट. यस फॉर समथिंग स्टिल व्हाइल वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एंड बीइंग इन एडवर्टाइजिंग एजेंसी, आई कैन टेल यू सो मेनी लॉन्ग फिल्म्स वी आर डूइंग टुडे. वी नेवर हैड एन अपॉर्चुनिटी. आवर क्रिएटिव गाइज आर हैविंग अ बॉल दीज डेज, बिकॉज the digital media releases cheaper than television programming. So they are films which are 4 minutes, 3 minutes, which we never saw in advertising. Maybe in countries where media is cheaper, like Sri Lanka and all, when I go and work there and I see, yes, they're like making 1.5, 2 minutes films there. But in India, everything was 30 seconds. In the West also, 30 seconds. But today, digital media is also allowing you to tell short stories. And those are required for to deliver certain emotions and to build certain brands. Because, see, if you narrowly will see, again I'm saying, you will have to deploy your forces. You will have to, today, agility is very important. Kahan par kis cheez ki zarurat hai, ye nirnay lena, pehle ki tarah, if you're looking for a formula, if you're looking for an algorithm which will crack it for you, that algorithm will also have to constantly update itself. AI will also have to be, see, AI is the future. A lot of AI will be done. Even in the world of script writing where I dabble into. You know, the recent phenomena is this AI software called Benjamin, which has been registered as a writer. Now, Benjamin has already delivered 2 scripts. So in future, you will see a lot of AI scripts which will come out. Again, what kind of scripts will come from AI? When you have a formulaic solution, it will come out. But I give you an example. I go to attend a funeral of someone. I'm telling you the difference between AI's creativity and the human creativity. Now you go to attend a funeral, and I stand next to the funeral pyre of somebody, some relative or some friend's family. I can see what is happening around me. I can smell the flesh and the burning smell of the flesh also. Not that I'm going to share how I feel about this burning smell, but something, that smell is there in my subconscious. It might even smell like some burning flesh or some roasted, say, meat. Those things are happening in me. Those are called first-hand experiences. I come back and I write a poem about this experience. This poem is available to AI as a data. But my multiple and minute nuanced experiences which have gone into my every cell, they are not. See, this experience is not responsible for producing one piece of poem or one piece of song or one piece of story. It is capable of producing multiple stories because this has sensorially been consumed by me. So that sensorial consumption which has happened to me, which happens to a human anatomy and human mind, is not available. Its production in the second hand information is available. So that difference will always be there between the way AI will approach creativity and the way humans will approach creativity.
That's a good point. In fact, I wanted to ask you a follow-up question. Tell us practically, how is data analytics changing the, role of a creative director, somebody who's writing scripts, somebody who's writing advertising? And then on the other hand, you have, platforms like YouTube where so much of AI data analytics is also doing that. So for a creative director today, how is his life changing? How is his or her life changing, given that there is so much data and analytics around us?
Oh, it helps. In fact, it helps precision. See, it's like, main ek poem sunana ki aapne ka ek poem sunaiye. To main, generally, I'll judge my audience. I'll say what kind of people are sitting here. Inko kitni Hindi aati hai. इनको इनको मीटर की समझ कितनी होगी, ये किस तरह की चीज़ समझेंगे, और मैं उस तरह से एक पोएम चूज़ करूँगा. अब मैं वो जो पोएम चूज़ करूँगा उसका निर्णय मैं इस आधार पर लूँगा कि सबके समझ में आ जाए, ठीक है ना. हो सकता है कि मैं थोड़ा सा ज़्यादा डिफ़िकल्ट लैंग्वेज जिसमें यूज़ की हो या ज़्यादा जिसको मैं अपने स्तर से नुआंस समझता हूँ वो ना सुनाऊँ. I feel that, that I need to appeal to everyone here. Some people would know the language less, some people are more into it. But suddenly I've been told, you're sitting with 5 budding poets who all write well. My choice will change. The selection I will make will change. That's what data does to you as a creative person. You know what? If you can target, you can be more nuanced in your writing and your creation, if you know your target audience well, you're not trying to appeal to everyone. It's not en masse you're going. You're going selective. And if you're going selective, your nuance will increase, your approach will become more intricate, and that's what a creative person should understand from data. You should not fear data. You should befriend it. You should not fear AI. You should befriend it. Because eventually, I think the human mind has immense capability. As far as the technology is your slave, the world will be fine. If the fear is when you fall slave to the technology. So human mind does not have to become lazy and have to always understand you have to proceed, you have to lead the AI and technology in a direction which is for human good. Because human good, see, AI's problem would always be what is the anchoring of AI? See, the human civilization is anchored in some human good. Ek value system mein hum log anchor hote. When you are faced with a situation, what decision I should take? You go to your, we say, listen to your conscience. So where is the conscience of AI? AI does not have a conscience. AI is very ruthless. AI is dry. Humans have conscience. If you have to take a decision in the morning, your mother is not well and there is a presentation, I'm sure that everybody in this room will say, there's no question of debate. I'm going to take my mother to the hospital. To hell with everything else. Where does this power come from? This power comes from conscience. AI will always have the problem. When you, the decision is left to AI, AI, where is AI anchored, will always be a question. Humans are anchored spiritually, emotionally, in a society, in a human good, and that collective anchoring is what gives us the direction. So as far as that human is leading AI or leading technology, we are in good hands.
Absolutely. No denial about that. We don't, I mean, there's no choice but not to fear technology, right? Tell me, let me move to a slightly different topic. You've, you know, over the last few years, you've also been very deeply involved with a lot of political advertising that's been going around. And how do you see political advertising and the role content has played in that? And I say this because, you know, if you look at the, you know, current incumbent, look at, for example, take our prime minister, who's himself such a, you know, important and popular face of, you know, the party and the government. What do you do when you sit down and create, you know, advertising for a, you know, party like that, which on the sheer force of a personality is able to, you know, steamroll opposition, win elections? So where does the role of political advertising come in, and what is the role of content within that piece?
See, good thing about the current regime and current people in power is that they don't have a baggage. So they very clearly are ready to listen to anything which works. Now, it's an open source thing for them. It could be a song, it could be a joke, it could be anything. So the understanding of what content world is instinctively understood very well. Because you don't have X number of campaigns to fall back and say, oh, in that election that worked, in that election, so we should go that way. See, sometimes what happens is you have to unlearn. In a lot of successful brands have to unlearn and reinvent. That baggage not being there, I think their understanding of the content and how content works has been pretty much there. So they have used content from open source beautifully. And in this entire world, which is open source, and you're going to allow, I'm sure you're going to ask me this question, where do advertising agencies see themselves tomorrow in this? See, as far as advertising agencies are ready to collaborate, see, tomorrow's model is collaborative model. A lot of things will simultaneously happen. And you understand what your brand. See, today, consumer is changing their preferences very fast. They are evaluating things themselves, and they are deciding, no, last time I used this, this time I'm going to use that. They're very experimental. They are very experimentative. There are also a lot of information available. So they are changing their mind very fast. Companies are also redefining themselves. From Apple, you become Apple Inc. You know, you've seen that how companies have redefined their domain where they function. They're broad basing themselves. They are assimilating. In that, I think more than the brand, I think it's the company which breaks that brand and responsible. The company's raison d'etre, company's philosophy is very, very important. What do you see yourself as? Your principles are very, very important. It's very, see, tomorrow's world is so much crowded with so many brands together. Only the ones which have a deeper connect with the consumer, deeper connect, which they might not be able to articulate, but instinctively go towards, are the brands which will work. So what will an agency do? Agency would be truly be a custodian of that brand. So that deeper connect is ensured. You might go and play in the world. Aap khul ke kheliye duniya mein. Lekin kahin na kahin, aap patang ki tarah udiye, jiski door kisi ke haath mein hai. Panchi ki tarah mat udiye, ki kabhi kisi ki chhat pe baith jata hai, kabhi kisi ki chhat pe. To wo patang ki tarah, you have to fly a kite.
And we have very good examples of what you're trying to say in, you know, some of the campaigns you've done with Reckitt Benckiser for brands like Dettol,
yes,
and some of those brands. And
so
you know,
Dettol,
how
I wrote this line called Dettol ka dhula. Now, coming from the cultural insight, kya dudh ka dhula? So when I was presenting to the client, I said that, kya can we be the last word? Last word hota hai. Apne ko kya samajhte ho? Dettol ka dhula? We say, khud ko kya samajhte ho? XYZ. Raja Harishchand. Everything has a last word. Can we be the last word in hygiene? And that's where Dudh Ka Dhula and Dettol Ka Dhula came and we started working. It's not only about pronouncing that line. See, in Thanda Matlab Coca-Cola, do the same thing. Not trying to pronounce it again. It's about living up to it. Nothing else is thanda matlab Coca-Cola. Dettol Ka Dhula is being the last word in that category. So how do you become the last word? You have to live up to it. So we went to the social. We saw our Honorable Prime Minister's campaign on Swachh Bharat. We thought, it's right up our alley. Why shouldn't we also be part of this campaign? And Dettol became very much part of this campaign. We even went to Kumbh, where we did not talk about why we are here, but very clearly, which is the ultimate place for cleansing, for purity, we had stalls there, which people were using. So you are subliminally associating yourself being the last word. And that's how you have to work. And that's what a brand custodian will do. That cannot be done by ad hoc creators, which will come and contribute. They can tell you beautiful stories. They can tell you how to use medium. I have a lot of respect for the content creators. But the anchoring of it, not that they can't do it. It's just that somebody has to dedicate himself or herself, or the company has to take the custodianship. I think tomorrow, advertising agencies will have to take their custodianships very seriously. As far as they do that, I don't see anything wrong in tomorrow's advertising future.
I think that's a very excellent point, because you see a lot of brands these days gravitating more and more towards, you know, content curators. They're like new shining girlfriends, and you know, the hand is still with the wife, but you know, they are going more and more towards those, you know, content curators, and a lot of them are doing hit and trials, which are working out, not working out. You know, some of the content curation companies have raised humongous monies at good valuations, which is fantastic. But what you're saying makes so much sense in terms of, you know, agencies, as long as they understand they are the original brand custodians and they don't try to compete with the content curators but complement what they're doing, they will keep their relevance. The more you try and compete with them, then, well, you know, in some cases you will lose out, because you know you cannot match.
I mean, you look at what is happening on platforms like TikTok. Like consumer itself, like you've got a huge amount of talent there. Sometimes it's impossible to beat. I ask my creative directors and copywriters, I said, look at this piece of creation. No? This is done by some housewife somewhere, and it's lost so many hits and it's making sort of, it's so viral. And they happily accept that, you know, it's a defeat. They say, this I would never have thought of. Now that's possible, because human mind is amazing. Somewhere deep down, it's not that wo kisi ki bapoti hai, ki wo ek स्वयं की ऑफिस के किसी कमरे में एक तरह के दिखने वाले शख्स के जहन में ही वो वाहिद ख्याल आएगा, वो कहीं भी किसी भी जगह किसी को भी आ सकता है. इट कैन अकर टू एनी वन. आई थिंक वी विल हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट यू विल गेट अ लॉट ऑफ दीज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशंस कमिंग फ्रॉम वेरियस पार्ट्स, बट एज फार एज वी हैव द इंटेलिजेंस, वी हैव द एक्सेप्टेंस फॉर ऑल दिस, वील बी एबल टू असिमिलेट, वील एबल टू कोलैबोरेट. एंड आई थिंक वी नॉट, वी आर स्टिल कॉन्डिसेंडिंग. सी वी स्टिल where I'm not bothered about traditional advertising versus modern advertising or digital world or content. It actually never occurred to me. I constantly explored various facets of creativity myself, so it never sort of, this compartmentalization never worried me. What worries me is condescension. What worries me is that you are condescending towards that I know better. Hey, I am the creative director, I've gone to this particular college, school, or I have facility with the lexicon, I am better. No, today's world does not, it success can come from anywhere. So there is no prerequisite to it. So as far as you have humility, and tomorrow's world is going to bet on the horse, not on the jockey. So as far as you know how to bet on the horse, you would win.
Well made point. I want to ask you, about the movie business. You've done a seamless transition from being a, lyricist, a poet, to an advertising person, a creative person, into the, movie industry. What are the few things that, and a lot of the, last few years, if you see the journey in the last few years, you actually started this trend of writing for patriotic movies, starting from Bhag Milka Bhag, now going on to Manikarnika this year, and you've done quite a few of them in between. Tell us, what are the things, a few key things that the movie business can teach brand builders? A lot of people have also made the transition from advertising to the movie business as directors and so on and so forth. But what are the things that the movie business can teach the brands?
See, movie business broadly defines things. So when I was doing Rang De Basanti, I called it a patriotic film. Khoon Chala, I think, was a patriotic song. But when I come to, say, a Manikarnika, where a different kind of patriotism of that time, I was depicting of Rani Lakshmi Bai's time. Ki main rahun ya na rahun, Bharat ye rehna chahiye. Desh se pyar to har pal ye kehna chahiye. Now that is a different kind of patriotism. That's like love for your country. Sometime questioning the mujhe khud ko bhi. I wrote a song called Satyamev Jayate for Satyamev Jayate series. Amir did, and I'd written four lines. Hum mujhe khud ko bhi hai tatolna, kahin hai kami to hai bolna, kahin daag hai to chupaye kyon, hum sach se nazre hataye kyon. So khud ko badalna hai agar, badlunga main tere liye, sholon pe chalna hai agar, chal dunga main tere liye. Ye bhi ek tarah ka patriotism hai. All kinds, there are different expressions of it. Sometimes you're questioning, that's also patriotism. Sometimes you are absolutely in love with your country and you're looking, your eyes have swelled up with pride seeing a Chandrayaan. That's also patriotism. But there is. So in the film, as you can see, they're not narrowly defined. They have all kinds of, because there are a lot of open source happening there. That's what we need to learn. Also, I think what we need to learn is they call it spade a spade. And if something does not work, yes, it is tough. Yes, there are heartbreaks there. On a Friday, the fate is decided, as they say. But they are very quick to accept that it didn't work. In advertising, what happens at time, we are not, their egos are bigger. And we want to repeat the campaign. See, template everybody wants to crack. So franchise always happens. Everybody would want to crack a template which can give you easy money. That's a human nature. That I've cracked a formula to great entertainment. The thing is, where to stop, when to call it a day, where to draw a line, is something which we need to learn from them. Because the stakes are higher, people are quick to move on. I think we need to quickly move on to something. And today's world, things don't don't live for too long. So you have to make sure you're moving on, you're reinventing yourself, and that should become almost part of your being, rather than, you know, somebody telling you, reinvent yourself. Reinventing yourself should become kind of, you should be in rhythm with it. And that's the need of the hour today in advertising.
Correct. Tell me, I'm sure you come across dozens of ideas of content, you know, on a weekly basis. Prasoon also chaired the jury for our Indian Content Marketing Awards 2 years back, and he had, you know, very significant nuggets to share. What is your secret formula when you evaluate, you know, content, when you look at a piece of content? What is your formula of, you know, judging it and seeing whether it is worthy of, you know, being executed or not?
See, one thing is, of course, being a brand builder and a brand custodian, I feel it has to do justice and live up to the brand's promise. It has to be in sync with it. Yeah, that's very, very important that we're expressing the DNA of it. Then something which is called andaze bayan. How is it being said? What and how? What it should be in sync with the DNA, and how is where the craft comes in. And I think I'm a sucker for craft. I feel same thing. Like, you know, there's an old poem which says, what is love, you know, says, Hazar bar zamana yahan se guzra hai. Nai nai si hai kuch teri reh guzar phir bhi. Ye husn ishq to dhoka hai, sab magar phir bhi. Hazar bar zamana yahan se guzra hai. Nai nai si hai kuch teri reh guzar phir bhi. Nai nai si kyun hai wo reh guzar? Kyunki to andaaze bayan uska hai. Same two people have fallen in love again and again. So many times I have written love songs. Tere haath mein likha hai, to phir ye bhi likha hai, tu bin bataye mujhe le chal kahin. Just love between two people, how many times can it be said? That's where the art of and the craft comes in. And I think in the new era and the new world, we need to pay more emphasis to craft. Craft to basuri ki tarah hai, dhol ke sur mein craft kahin dab na jaye. Iska hame dhyan rakhna hai. I tell my creative guys, I say, yes, sometimes ideas, the amusement is very high. The app is very exciting. But don't forget the craft. Don't forget the design. Don't forget the nitty-gritties of it. I got just relaunched the certificate design for CBFC. You would have seen that. We just launched a few days back. I sort of tried to recreate the certificate. You'll see a very different film certificate in a few months from now. And try to incorporate interaction in it. In today's certificate, you can even watch a trailer through a certificate. You just have to take your phone and it will show you the trailer. So made it very interactive, the new certificate design. But in that design, see, the thing is that things in the technology is very powerful. It amuses you. So where does the craft go? And the craft has longevity. That andaze bayan has to be there. So that's what the combination of what and how I look for when, to answer your question.
Fantastic. Last two questions and then we'll throw the house open. Where do you see this content advertising industry headed in the next 3-5 years, given all the proliferation of data, you know, morphing of platforms, you know, television merging into digital becoming something? So where do you see this, how do you see this entire thing play out over the next 3 to 5 years, and what are the implications this has for a creative person?
The chaos will be less. Today we are overwhelmed with it. I can see wherever, whichever forum I go to, I meet the students, I meet the marketeers, I meet the advertising people, the creative fraternity. I feel we are overwhelmed with what is happening in technology, how so many multiple mediums and consumer behavior, the touch points. We are overwhelmed. I think that will settle down. I feel the chaos will be less. We would have come to terms with the new world much more than what we are today. So I will, you will see much more sanity in the room. I can tell you that.
Why do you think chaos will be lesser?
Because everything is at nascent stage right now. See, time tells so many things sound very promising. But kuch hi cheeze hoti hai jo vakt ki aandhi mein theher paati hai. Sab kuch nahi theherta hai. Bahut kuch khatam ho jata hai. Kuch ped jo jhuke huye the, kuch shaakhein jo jhuki hui thi, tufaan ke jaane ke baad dikhti hai, achha ye bhi thi. Aur kuch toot ke gir chuki hoti hai. So, after it's a stormy times we are living in, but this will settle. And humans have a huge amount of adaptability. I look at my mother, who's 80 years old. she very with great aplomb she deals with the technology. My father doesn't. He's an analog person. So I can see both very clearly. He for him a button is a switch. So touch screen for him is like this. So he touches the screen like this. He touches an app like this. On the same time, seeing my mom, who's very, very, you know, she has two iPads. She's communicating with her family. She's communicating with her friends. And that, so you will see adaptability of human mind also coming into picture. Some people will not be able to adapt. Some will adapt. And that will create a world which probably change happened. This is a disruptive change. See, cinema also came in. Cinema also redefined the way we looked at advertising. In fact, I don't want to get into the details of it, but people who have watched Mad Men would know that how they have also depicted that advertising agencies tried to have even filmmakers inside the film, inside their agency earlier. Then they realized this is not our job. This should be done third party. So then it was left to the third party. But in the beginning, it confused people. I remember when earlier days when I joined advertising, even a, you know, telecine, which nobody even talks in. If I tell my creative guys, a telecine used to be discussed. Telecine hone ja raha hai picture ka. Singapore jana hai, bhai, kaun jayega? Is par bada discussion hota tha. Aaj, when the telecine happened, whether it happens or it doesn't happen, whether he's shooting in digital format, he's shooting on red, on what, that is not discussed. So I think certain things will become irrelevant, certain jargons. I fear the creative people who drop too many jargons today. You know, I fear the digital people, creative people who come and tell you, you know, they scare you with so much of jargon. Anybody coming, somebody who's coming from a business school drops a lot of Venn diagrams and a lot of jargons at you, fear that person. Person is not talking a sense. The sense wala baat jo hai, wo mudde pe aata hai. Because jargons mein aapko uljhayega wo vyakti jo apna kaam nahi janta. Jargons to aapke liye hai yaar, wo dusre ke liye thodi hai. The tools are for you. Tools are not to be flaunted. So if somebody is flaunting tools, doubt that there is something wrong out there.
Tell me, I'm sure that you've been asked this question very, very often. I mentioned the Happy Dent Creative when I introduced you. And you must have answered this question dozens of times. Just to recall for us, what gave you inspiration for that idea?
Yeah, Happy Dent will always stay special. And special for various reasons. If I tell you the history of that, that product is an Italian product. Perfetti is an Italian company. I've been working on building that brand from a very small office. It used to be in a house in south of Delhi. Ek ghar ke upar unke marketing manager rehte the, niche unka office hota tha. Tab se main us pe kaam kar raha hu. And Happy Dent was a brand which was given to us as something which has worked in Italy and in the Europe market. And they had given us an ad, which was about a girl who's supposed to go on a date. And since this gum brightens your teeth, so she looks at her teeth in the mirror and then decides not to brush the teeth, but have the gum. And uske daant chamak jate hain aur uska date ho jata hai mamla. To humne kaha ki yaar ye to nahi kaam karta, Hindustan mein daanton ko itni seriously koi nahi leta. Ki daanton ki wajah se maine ladke ko select kar liya, ya ladki ko select kar liya, daant kamal the sab. Hamare, we are a punching nation. ओके हमारे यहाँ दांत को लास्ट में देखेगा वो कि ये दांत तो गड़बड़ होंगे कुछ फंसा होगा कुछ निकाल रहा होगा आई थिंक द गर्ल विल ऑल्सो इग्नोर दैट द बॉय विल ऑल्सो इग्नोर कि दांत के चक्कर में नहीं पड़ूंगा यार मैं सो हाउ डू यू गेट इन टू द माइंड्स ऑफ द पीपल हियर सो लेट्स हैव लिटिल फन लेट्स नॉट टेक देम सो सीरियसली कैन वी हैव फन विद इट सो द फर्स्ट कमर्शियल एंड सो वॉट हैपन द क्लाइंट सेड दैट नो बट दिस हैज वर्क्ड इन द अदर मार्केट्स यू हैव टू डू आई सेड ओके दैट विल डब in the Hindi language. And parallelly, I went ahead with my own money. I went to the film director. I said, "Arey, mujhe commercial shoot kar de." So Dadu was the Black Magic production. He was very kind and he came forward. And we shot a commercial. I don't know whether you've seen that. That was the first Happy Dent commercial, where there is this photographer who's basically using his assistant as a flash bulb. हंसने की आवाज़ आती है और यू डोंट नो वेयर द फ्लैश बल्ब इज कमिंग फ्रॉम एक्चुअली वो एक गम खाता है दांत खुलता है उसका फ्लैश बल्ब यूज करता है उसी का सर वो उसको लगाता है उस तरह से एंड वी रिसर्च्ड बोथ there was no comparison. Now, Indians loved the photographer. So 2 versus 9, that got scored 9 out of 10, and that other one 2. So of course they ran it. And the impact of that started, they started seeing. This product originally was supposed to be sold from the chemist shop. Very limited ambition product. Today it sells in every pawn shop. And then later on, I did that. Can we take this metaphor even higher and start thinking of a world where every bulb is a human? And I remember telling this story to the client that ek aadmi hai, he's employed as a bulb in a palace. And he's getting late for his work. And raaste mein usko saare uske dost milte hain, koi street lamp ka bulb hai, koi swimming pool ke niche ka bulb hai. He says, are you serious? I said, yeah, I'm serious. And it was complete, the faith that the last one had worked. We got that license. And my friend Ram Madhvani executed it so well. And we had a great historical commercial, which became an epic. People started reading a lot. You know, people talk about slavery in that. People talk about subliminally. That's true. Later on, I thought, क्या ऐसा वर्ल्ड हो सकता है जहाँ सब कुछ एम्प्लॉय मतलब लोग बल्ब को एम्प्लॉय करें? यस, इट इज़ पॉसिबल, बिकॉज पुराने ज़माने में राजा लोग पीछे खजुए रखते थे, खजुए पीठ खुजाने के लिए, वो ऐसे कहते थे तो वो पीठ खुजाता था. सो इट वॉज पॉसिबल इन दिस कंट्री दैट अ बल्ब इफ वुड लाइट अप यू नो द रूम वुड बी एम्प्लॉयड, द ह्यूमंस विल बी एम्प्लॉयड. सो द शैंडलियर, द लास्ट शॉट हैड अ शैंडलियर विच वॉज वी गॉट मलखम आर्टिस्ट्स fabulously who created that chandelier. And it is not that none of that is done on a special effect. Everything is done real. Today, you know, you can mount these things. But those days, we didn't. We just, you know, shot it. And later on, of course, we won in Cannes and everywhere, and it became the most awarded commercial in the world, and the only Indian commercial ever who's been
top. That's right, as I said, amongst the top 20 ads of world, all time, voted by the Gun Report. With that, thank you so much. Another a big round of applause
to
Prasoon. I see the clock has run out of time. If we have any questions, we can pass some mics around. You can raise your hand up before you ask any questions. I see Dharmendra raising his hand. Can we get a mic to him? Do introduce yourself while you ask the question, please. Thank you.
My name is Dharmendra Rai. I'm a trainer. I train on subjects like mind mapping and brain literacy and invisible selling, behavioral economics. My question was, there's a lot of data to prove that the average intelligence of a human being on the planet is reducing. And content has a lot to do with it. For example, the cinema franchise with the greatest revenues is the Avengers series. Now, it may be great commercially, but in terms of content, it's infantile content. So I just wanted your views on that. I mean, what kind of planet are we creating?
See, if I become politically correct, I'll say, nahin, aajkal ke bachche bahut buddhiman hai. If you really ask me, I feel audiovisual actually dumbs you down. See, audiovisual consumption kaise hota hai? Aap chehra dekhiye us shakhs ka. Uska muh khula hua hai. आंखें फटी हुई हैं, उसकी कोई काफी इंटेलिजेंट लुक नहीं है वो. दैट्स नॉट अ वेरी इंटेलिजेंट लुक. लुक एट समवन हू इज रीडिंग अ बुक, थोड़ा पढ़ता है, थोड़ा साइड में रखता है, सोचने लगता है, बड़ा अच्छा प्यारा सा लुक है. आई मीन नॉट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द ओल्ड वर्ल्ड, बट दैट्स हाउ इट इज. ऑडियो विजुअल इज एक्चुअली डिशिंग आउट एवरीथिंग. एक बार गुलजार साहब और मैं वी वर इन जयपुर लिटरेचर फेस्टिवल एंड देयर वाज अ सेशन वी वर डूइंग विद किड्स. So we started talking. I said, Guzar sahab said, kya baat kare aaj Prasoon sahab? Maine kaha, let's talk about Chudail. Says, there was a time that everybody had a Chudail, a witch. Because wo kitab mein padhte the ya dadi ki kahani sunati thi ki beta ek aise Chudail thi. To wo apni Chudail sochta tha, kaun hogi Chudail, kaisi hogi. Usne apne dimag mein kalpana ki hui thi. There was his own witch. The symbols work all out of his or her life. Later on, everybody had a jhadu wali chudail. Sabki ek hi ho gayi. So sabki alag alag tab hoti hai jab you leave room for imagination. So more imagination you will kill. The aankh band karke sochna, isliye introspection ko itna is land mein, looking inside, sab kuch andar hai, ye bola gaya. I wrote a song called Maula Muhammad Muqaddar ki kar do Maula. Usme ek maine antra likha hai, ek khushbu aati thi, main bhatakta jata tha. Reshmi si maya thi aur main takta jata tha. Jab teri gali aaya, sach tabhi nazar aaya, mujhme hi wo khushbu thi, isse tune milwaya. Now, this looking inside, that is introspection. I think so much of content, to come to your point, so much of content is actually making you look so, all the time outside. You're not introspecting. You're not closing your eyes. You're not looking and touching things which are tactile. You're not looking at this bottle. You've decided that you are looking at a bottle. Now, this gaze which is dying, this introspection which is dying, is costing us in intelligence for sure. I feel that. There'll be a lot of scientists, and I don't want to refute them. They will have their own study to tell you that maybe we have become quicker or faster, our processing has become faster. There would be, of course, those points there. But to me, what I feel, yes, there is too much of content is giving you sab kuch paros rahe aap. You're giving every solution. You're not allowing the mind's fertility to produce solutions.
Thank you.
Any other questions? Yeah, Kavya. Okay, there's a gentleman right next there, then we'll come to you after that. Right there, Krishna.
Okay, my name is Amit Jain and I'm from Volvo Cars. My question to you, sir, is you travel to a lot of other countries and work in different countries. What is the basic difference in creative process that you see that we do in India and how it is done in other countries?
See, depends on which country you are in. If you say the Western world, it's, I would say, willy-nilly more organized than us, more structured. We are more fluid than them, I would say, and they are more structured. So even for a presentation, I see the way they work. You know, we are working till the very last moment, and we are allowing that to happen. They would not. They will call it a day, one day, and they'll say, okay, now we are having a dry run, and this is it. So they are more structured. So in terms of process, much better. China also is much better in process. We, even in our presentations with our clients, I think I would not be, you know, I'm not being condescending or anything, but I think I find Indians fairly more intellectual than most of the parts in the world I travel to. Our thought is much more powerful. I think a rigor to detailing is less than many countries. To detailing ka jo pain hai, the amount of pain in detailing many countries take, India doesn't take. But India really enjoys the thought process. Our thoughts are fine and beautiful, but our execution and detailing needs to be much more, you know, we need to have much more rigor in it.
Thank you, sir.
Hi.
Great.
Am I audible?
Yeah.
Okay.
Kavya, can we get a mic here to Kavya? Oh, right. Oh, I can't see from here. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah? Am I audible?
Yes.
Okay, hi. My name is Deeksha. I'm from Star. I look after content marketing with the distribution team. I'm picking up three things from what Prasoon said before I ask my question. So first thing you said is, aapko patang ki tarah hona chahiye, which should always be rooted in some way or the other. Na ki panchi ki tarah jo ki dal dal aur paat paat karte rehte hain. The second thing you said was that today the consumer preferences are changing at a very, very rapid pace, which is very true. And the third thing is that we are going through a very, very transient phase, which is going to probably calm down in times to come. So the question is, what should brands do in this scenario? Should brands define and redefine themselves according to the change in consumer preferences? Or should we kind of wait for the pace to hold on and then define their strategies to target consumers? Because there's so much chaos in the market. And if you look at the chaos, the previous conventional marketing modes like a radio, a ATL, a hoarding, etc., they're dying down. They're not capturing the attention as they used to because there's so much content available towards you. So what should be the right way to engage the consumers today? What should brands do?
First of all, understand the reality. I think closing your eyes and thinking that this is not the world we are living in. The reality is that's the truth. You know, like, look at parenting. I mean, today's parenting and the time our parents brought us up is very different. We listened to our parents yes, of course, we deviated a little bit, but they could pretty much control us. Look at the parenting today, how challenging parenting is. The child is exposed to not only the do's and don'ts which the mother or father tells, but to the videos they are watching, the social media they are interacting with. They're interacting with so much in the world that so much is beamed at them that you need to understand that counseling is very, very important. Sitting with them is very, very important. Constantly reassuring them about world, because such rapid change also impacts the human mind. A lot of child psychologists have told me that, you know, children are losing faith. Where do they anchor themselves? What is that? Where can they rely on? Everything is changing. Everything is transient. So the faith in that we are there. The mom's saying that I am there. Kisi ne hum log, I did a campaign on suicide around the examination time. And that time I wrote a phrase which Dr. Harish Shetty, who was expert, he really liked. I said, there was a time when if I have not scored good marks, I knew my result is coming, I'll run away to my grandmother's room and hide myself there. And my grandmother was least concerned about, they were concerned about more laughing and happily enjoying life with you than your marks. So she would shield me. Koi kuch nahi bolega usko. Okay, bas ho gaya. Now she's the eldest, more in the family, so nobody's saying, so I'm shielded by that. So wo kaha hai? That child today requires that. Please keep drawing a parallel between this and the consumer today. And that child today requires reassurance that I am there. Because if that is there, the suicide rate which we're talking about will come down. Because somebody out there is unconditionally loving me. Not loving me because I've got good marks or not. So that grandmother or that mom's role, wo maa ki god, maut ki god na le. Jab tak wo hai, the reassurance is there. So in the consumer's mind, there has to be, the brands have to comfort you, brands have to hold hand, brands have to, is badalti bheed mein, kahin na kahin, sab kuch, ek phrase hai, Nasir Kazmi, ek shayar hai, unka hai, manus ajnabi, known stranger. So you have to surprise the consumer, yet comfort them. You have to surprise them because otherwise they will say, you've been taken for granted. What are you doing for me? Oh, you think I'll always be there. So you have to keep on surprising the consumer and yet comfort them. That's what they require. They don't want to run away. They just don't want to be taken for granted. So handhold your consumer. Tiptoe into their subconscious and stay there.
Thank Fantastic you, nugget. Emotional bonds are the only real bonds that last. Big round of applause to Prasoon Joshi for spending time on such a rainy day.